In the real numbers, I have told you about the real numbers. What do we call the real numbers? So now I will tell you Euclid's division lemma. Euclid's division lemma. Let's see what is this. Euclid's division lemma. So first you should know what do we call the lemma. What is lemma? So lemma is a proven statement. Any statement which is already proved by the observation or by some other way, it is already proved. So with the help of this one proved statement, you are proving some another statement. So this is known as the lemma. So lemma is a proven statement to prove another statement, or theorem you can say also, to prove another statement or theorem. So this we call lemma. So lemma is a proven statement to prove some other statement or some other theorem. We call it a lemma. So now what is Euclid's division lemma? Euclid's division lemma, it says that given any two positive integers a and b, A and B, there exist integers Q and R such that A equals to B Q plus R, B into Q plus R. This is the Euclid's division lemma. Now, it is some boss line. What is this all? We will just understand it by some examples. Okay, what is this all about? There are two positive integers A and B. So for these two positive integers, there will be some other integers Q and R such that A is equal to BQ plus R. What is this all about? Let's say, check it. Let's say I have to divide 11 by 3. So it is going how many times? 3 times 9, so 2 is the remainder. Okay, so this 3 is known as divisor. This 3 is known as divisor. This 11 is called dividend. This 3 is known as quotient, and this 2 is remainder. Divisor, dividend, quotient, remainder. So 3 is dividing 11 how many times? 3 times, and 2 is the remainder. 3 times 9? 3 times 2. Now, if I multiply divisor and quotient, 3 is 9, and I add 2 there. So how much it will be? 3 is 9, 9 plus 2, 11. It means the dividend. The dividend is equal to what? Divisor multiply quotient. Divisor multiply quotient plus remainder. Plus remainder. If I multiply divisor and quotient and I add remainder, then I will get the dividend. Let's say I express this divisor as A, dividend as divisor as B, dividend at A, quotient as Q, and remainder as R. Dividend is A, divisor is B, quotient is Q, and remainder is R. So put these values here. Dividend is represented by A is equals to. Dividend is what here? 11. Divisor is how much? Divisor is 3. Multiply quotient is how much? 3. Plus remainder is 2. So you will get 3 is 9 plus 2, 11 you are getting. By the symbol I am writing it down. Dividend is represented by A. Divisor is represented by B multiply or into. Quotient is represented by Q plus remainder is represented by R. So this is the Euclid division. A is equal to BQ plus R. So this is nothing. This is this only. Dividend is equal to divisor multiply quotient plus remainder. This is the Euclidean. This you are already knowing it. You are already knowing it. This is only this. Dividend is equal to divisor multiply quotient plus remainder. This is the theorem. In short, you can say it like this also. Now, we will solve some questions regarding this lemma. Then you will get to know it clearly. What is this lemma all about? Okay, let's solve a numerical here questionnaire. Okay, and the question is from your NCERT book. I think it will be from the exercise. Question is, so that even positive even integers, I'm writing question here, so that even positive even integers is of the form 2q and odd integers is of the form 2q plus 1. This you have to prove. You have to prove that any even integer you take, these a and b are integers. Suppose these integers are even. So any integers is of the form 2q. So a will always be in the form of 2q. And odd integer, if a is odd, then it will be in the form of 2q plus 1. Let's check it. Let's say, let a is an integer. A is an integer. So I can write by Euclid's division lemma. So by Euclid's division lemma, A is equals to BQ plus R. A is equal to BQ plus R. Okay. So in place of B, what is written here? 2Q. So B is what? 2. So by you are dividing it A by 2. Okay. So there are two integers right now, A and 2. Okay. So let A and 2 are integers. A and 2 are integers. These are two integers. Okay. So if A and 2 are integers, so A will be equals to what? 2 is B. So B 2Q plus R by division lemma. Okay. Now one thing more. This R will always be less than B. Look here. This remainder will always be less than the divisor. So the R will always be less than B. But it may be equal to 0 also or greater than 0 also. So R will always be less than B, but it will be greater than equal to 0. Is it clear now? Yes. So now, so A is equal to 2Q plus R. So what will be the value of R? Where R is less than what? R is always less than B. So B is what here? 2. So R will be less than 2. R will be less than 2. But it can be equal to 0 also or greater than 0. So what are the values of R here? It implies R will be equals to, R can be 0, R can be 1. Only two values of R remainder. Remainder can be 0 also here and remainder can be 1. Remainder cannot be 2 here because 2 is the divisor. Is it clear? Now, let's study it. If R equals to 0. So put the value here. If R equal to 0, then A will be what? 2Q plus 0. So it implies A equal to 2Q. So any number you are multiplying by 2, it is an even number. Any number which is multiple of 2 is even number. So it means A is equal to 2Q. So even number is in the form of 2Q. So this you have to prove. So that even positive, even integer is of the form 2Q. I have proved it. Okay. Getting now? Now, I will put the value of R equal to 1 now. If R equals to 1. Now put the value here. It implies A will be equals to
2q plus
1. 2q plus 1. Now look.
If any even number, 2q is the even number, you are adding 1 there. So it will become odd number. Like 4, even number. 1 add there, 5. Odd number.
So 2q plus 1 is odd number. Okay.
So you can say that every even positive integer is of the form 2q. And odd integer is of the form
2q plus 1. Hence, proof. So you can write here. Hence, every positive even integer is of the form 2q.
Positive integer is of the form 2q. And odd integer is of the form 2q plus 1.
And odd integer is of the form 2q plus 1.
Hence proof. Okay. So if I say you some other example, I will give you now. Show that every even positive or even integer is of the form 4q or 4q plus 2. And odd integer is of the form 4q plus 1 or 4q plus 3. This also you can prove by the same Euclid's division lemma. Is it clear? Note it down. These sort of questions we will do. Some other questions are also. Okay? So just note it down.